So when we say here technology-based automated tools or appropriate mechanisms. So when we say appropriate mechanism, what does it mean? Like, does it mean that there can be a moderator which has an AI-assisted platform or a dashboard, and then if the moderator, and how many of, say, 10,000 videos are getting created on your platform in a day, how many of them get red flagged to the moderator? And if, say, we are saying that, okay, 50% of that content is getting red flagged to the moderator, then 5,000 videos are being seen by the moderator, then that means the company has knowledge of that content going onto the platform, then that means the company is no longer an intermediary or what? Like, what is the standard of benchmarking here that we are talking about? Like, automated tools, appropriate mechanism, when a person has seen it. So it's very vague. Like, there is a huge spectrum here. So it has to be clearly defined.
On the question that was posed earlier, will you stop being an intermediary? See, again, I go back to what I said earlier. All of this has to be looked at from the point of view of Section 79, then Section 79(1). At the end of the day, you may continue to be an intermediary for that particular instance where there is a primary law or an unlawful act that has been proved. For that particular instance, then you lose your intermediary safe harbor. It is not that you in general lose your intermediary safe harbor. Again, this is something that is being contested in courts today. And it's something which hasn't been decided one way or the other and is open to interpretation.
So effectively, let's say there's an intermediary that uses an algorithm to, like Facebook does, right, in case of if a user flags or if an automated tool flags something, it gets surfaced to the next level, and then you have human intervention looking at that.
Yes, at that level, it might lose its safe harbor protection.
So then let me ask you a slightly weird question. Does this also apply prior to that being flagged? Do they lose safe harbor for that content if automated tools effectively flag it to humans?
It will come from the time the actual knowledge came to the platform. Now, there is a lot of case laws around when does the intermediary cross that line between being an passive participant to being an active transmitter of information. The recent Louis Vuitton judgment, it very clear, in Delhi High Court, she laid down 15 criteria of what an e-commerce platform does. And she said the more you do it, the more you're in the danger of becoming an active participant.
So those 23 points in the Pratibha Singh judgment,
yes,
right? Yeah. Dalvies so versus Louboutin.
Yes.
Yeah.
So that is something where you become an active participant is a blurry line. But generally, where as soon as there is a human interface, you are in danger of losing your safe harbor protection.
At the point when a human who is... Are we saying that at the point when there is some human intervention possible, or there has been some human level of attention that has been given to the content by an employee of the company? Or, for example, if the intermediary company has outsourced this entire compliance to a third party who is acting on behalf of the company, that third party company, that vendor became aware about a certain content and was, say, failed to remove it, but the company was not made aware, then who's liable? Like, because that vendor is not an intermediary, but the company is. So that is also slightly vague. Because of this is very practical, because most of what I know, even Facebook or other platforms have outsourced a lot of these activities, moderation activities.
So I think my use of the term actual knowledge caused some confusion. So first is, which intermediary can claim a safe harbor provision? That intermediary necessarily needs to fit into a very straitjacket formula that they should not initiate, modify, select the recipient of the transmission. So the moment there is a human interface who is deciding whether this content should be continue to be on the platform or not, you are somehow violating the second criteria where you are modifying and selecting the receiver of the transmission. In that sense, you lose your intermediary safe harbor protection. The actual knowledge which Shreya Singhal talks about is specifically related to non-compliance of a takedown requirement. So just wanted to clarify that. In response to your question, the fact is that you have outsourced your responsibility to some other vendor. Ultimately, you will still remain liable for the acts of that vendor.
One is that, I just want to agree with the gentleman who said that Shreya Singhal actually talks about knowledge in terms of court or government. Also, bringing in the CDA Section 230 into that discussion in terms of, because there was a lady here who said that that's actual knowledge is only in terms of 79(3)(b). But actually, if you look at CDA 230, they say that an intermediary, a platform, is deemed not to have knowledge because of the free speech protection that that gives. So even if you look at it in the Indian context, I would agree with the gentleman who says that the sheer single definition of knowledge. Why? Because if you give platforms the right to automate without assigning knowledge to them, that, as per the logic of CDA 230, actually encourages platforms to take down content that may be child porn or the categories that you're talking about, without having to assume liability for not taking down other content that is speech protective. So it does two things. So that's why I agree with you, bringing in CDA 230, that we should go with his version of knowledge, not ma'am's, that it's not just restricted to 79(3)(b).
No, but this is an interesting point, that actually not having liability encourages action in some cases. But what about those entities that are necessarily allowing it to proliferate in that sense? Right? Then what happens there? You can't. I know you don't want to hold responsible intermediaries back in terms of doing what they have to do or attribute liability to them. But there are those who can completely self-regulation hasn't worked, right? And so, how do you deal with that situation now?
Yeah. So that's also where interesting comparison between India and the US. So, for example, if you look at CDA 230 in the US, there are many exemptions for this knowledge point. That means for criminal law, federal criminal law, for example, the protection that CDA 230 gives will not apply. Similarly, in India, if we see the point about unlawful content, that only applies to Article 19 sub 2. So the exemption that is there both in the US and in India is a limited exemption. So it's not like it's a free-for-all for platforms.
Like, we know YouTube's been using Content ID, etc. So one thing that AI has to some extent, more than other forms of unlawful content, been useful for is copyright and trademark infringement. So that can be looked into, at least to that extent, that it has worked.
There's a lot of fair users which has been taken down through Content ID as well.
Right.
So there are two sides to this. Yeah.